Varun.
Thank you, Dr. Navendu. Good morning again. Just a second. Yes, good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Varun Kharbanda, and I am based in Allahabad. I am going to be talking to you about print media and press, taking my first steps to publicity. So before we start that, see, advertising in our field is a very tricky and a slightly gray area. So we need to know what are the exact do's and don'ts that the MCI states that we can and cannot do as doctors. So a medical practitioner is only permitted to advertise regarding the following: when you're starting a practice, you're changing of type of practice, changing of address, temporary absence from duty, resumption of another practice, succeeding to another practice, or public declaration of charges. So there is a loophole here. We notice that there are hospitals that advertise life right, left, and center. The name of the doctor is something that cannot be advertised, should not be advertised. But a hospital or a brand, the services it offers, the kind of consultants it has, that can definitely be advertised. However, there are people, purists, who think that ethically that's wrong as well. But that's open to kind of your own judgment and your own interpretation of the laws. I think I covered that. Yeah, so starting with publicity, these are the few basic principles I want to touch on, because everything that you do in publicity revolves around these basic principles. First of all, the visibility of whatever you do. I think the previous speakers have touched, and others are also going to touch. Visibility is very important. You can't just put up a banner in one corner over one tree and hope that people will pass by and watch. You have to be strategic in doing whatever you're doing. It has to be placed strategically in a point where the maximum number of people are exposed to it, and so on. Whatever you put up has to be coherent. You can't bombard people with information. Most of the times you're putting up a banner or a poster, people are going to drive by in about 2 to 3 seconds. So you need to have content which hits home in the first second the person looks at it. You can't have a whole plethora of information, because that's not going to serve any purpose. It has to have instant appeal. It has to have something that is catchy. Dr. Samita was talking about having, you know, things that stand out. Also, you can always connect with generic messages like, you know, wish people a happy Independence Day or a happy Republic Day, and so on. You should never go overboard. See, there's a very thin line. I belong to the school of thought where I feel subtle is always good. But of course, there are people who go all out, who'll have advertisements all over. So that's again a personal choice. And economics, of course, you have to keep it under a budget, because at the end of the day, you have to get, you know, something out of it. So we'll talk about visibility first. Like I said, the location matters. These are two boards that we had, or two banners we had put up in Allahabad. Durga Puja is a big thing. So the first one is the banner. The second one is a larger picture, where you can see that anyone who is walking in the pandal will be facing the banner. So that will give at least 4 to 5 seconds of face time to our banner when the person is walking in. The rate for the putting up a banner in this pandal was same for all the banners. But we went and told them that we want it here. And because they had no objection, they should have actually charged us more. So we have to be strategic. The size should not be too big that it intimidates people, and should not be too small that, you know, it's difficult to read. Just the right size. It's always a good idea not to use loud colors like red and yellow. Then you just become a Unani or an Ayurvedi Vedshala. You have to, you know, maintain your decorum and the subtlety that comes with our profession. And like they say, a picture speaks 1,000 words. So characters or pictures are always better than detailed information about things, and they will drive home the point better. They have to be coherent. You have to have maximum information with minimum characters. Try not cluttering the boards. Bold and easy to understand. And you have to keep in mind the local factors as well. So an OPD board like this is probably no-no, because the patient will spend 5 minutes reading when you're available, when you're not, and in the end probably get confused. So try to keep your commitments simple, and relay the same to the patients. This will hit home. So patient knows that the patient will find you. I am available 10 to 12 on one day, 3 to 4 on the other day, etc. and so on. It should have instant appeal. You have to enumerate your unique points, offers and packages. We are having the Kumbh right now in Prayagraj, so we are offering free services to the Kumbh. And in our country, fortunately or unfortunately, anything free, you know, the word free is bound to pull people. So if you're doing something free, get it written big and bold, because that will draw in patients. Right now, our OPD is more of the free patients because of the Kumbh than our paid patients. And we are happy because we are getting footfall. And they are getting free consultation, so it's not too much that we are looking losing out on. We are getting surgeries out of that. We are getting people who are buying spectacles and taking their medicines. So all that is paid, but we are getting footfall. Try to connect with the generic message, like Independence Day and Republic Day messages. This is something we have put on radio in Allahabad. So before I make you hear it, most of the advertising in a small town, or probably for big towns also, it's always better to go for the vernacular languages, the local languages. If the language that I'm conveying my message to you will not work back in Allahabad. It has to be local, Hindi. Similarly with papers, we'll come to that. So this is a small message. That's running on the radio right now.
महेश नेत्रालय की तरफ से सभी प्रयागवासियों को गणतंत्र दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं. महेश नेत्रालय, Love the Road, Prayagraj.
So we've not marketed ourselves. We're not selling anything. We're just saying that we are wishing you, so that the name resonates with the people, because it's a new setup. So people need to get used to hearing that name. Similarly, we can, you know, you can have things like be safe from firecrackers, message from such and such place, or holy, if color goes into your eye, wash, and, you know, message from such, different things. So you're not directly advertising yourself, but it's a more positive feel. Like I said, never go overboard. It should be more of information and less of frank advertising. Do not use specific doctors' names, and not can, but you should mention specialties. You should go all out while enumerating your facilities, the services that you're offering. And all these things about guaranteed treatments and 100% 66 is a big no-no. Should never do things like that. So right now, the expenditure that we had earmarked for our advertising is about 4 to 6% of the turnover. It has to be high initially, because initially you have to make an impact. And later on, it can reduce. Also, all these radio and press and paper people, they are pretty open to bargaining as well. And as a favor, you can throw in free camps for their offices and all. And these things, like I said, free always works in our country, and you can get a pretty decent deal. Now, the specific methods of bargaining, I'm going to quickly go through them and I'll conclude my talk thereafter. So paper and magazines, like I said, always try to go for the vernacular dailies, the local language, because they always have more circulation, and the people who read that, you know, you'll be reaching to a larger crowd. Always good to involve yourself. They have special sections sometimes, like Allahabad has Dainik Jagran, which has something called Hello Doctor. So there the patients call you and you have to answer their questions. It's not, it should be actually for a radio, but they print whatever happened. So yesterday this doctor was there, he answered these questions, and they printed, and make sure you keep a cutting of it, make sure you display it in your hospital, so people should know that you are important enough to be called. Then if you have camps, etc., you can inform the newspapers, and informing about camps in newspapers is essentially free publicity, because you're not paying anything for it, they're just coming to get news from you. We can advertise in journals. So journals like this one, we have to kind of you know, ration out what we want and what we don't want. Do you want the doctors of the place to know you if you have a referral practice? Do you want the general public to know you if you have a general practice? So there are magazines which are for the general public. There are magazines which are just for doctors. So that is a very individually based decision that everyone has to make. Sorry. Pamphlets, yeah, this is something which excites me, because very early on I realized that distributing pamphlets is also very scientific. You should hand them out in the newspapers, and make sure you should do that in the first week of every month, because a lot of the working janta has run out of their monthly paisa by the end of the month. So even if they have the information around the 25th or the 30th of the month, they can't act on that information. Beginning of the month, people are excited. They are full of, you know, they've just been replenished. Their salaries have come in. So it's always a good idea to kind of ration I'm sorry, but to kind of ration when you want to hit out. You can't send pamphlets every day. So maybe 3-4 days every month, beginning the first 3-4 days, and it really helps. Banners and hoardings, like I said, minimum information and plain background. So this is something which has started now. In all our cities, we have LED boards where traditional hoardings used to be. So we've got a 20-second or 15-second clip made, which this is not running. Sorry, I'll probably show it at the end of the talk. So it's just a clip with a background music, and you know, it shows the name of the hospital and just says, take care of your eyes, etc., etc. Again, the basic idea here is to create a recall value, is for people to know that something like this exists. We are not saying that we are the best, we do this, we are blah, blah, nothing. Just get the name into the head, and they will be curious. That will create curiosity for them to walk back in. You can associate with events. Like I said, Kumbh Mela is happening in Allahabad right now. So there is a major event called Netra Kumbh that is happening. We go there, we see patients, and we're seeing something like 5,000 patients a day. Why? Because free glasses are being given. So again, if you're there, that much visibility, and all you have to do is give about a couple of hours of your time. It's always a win-win situation. I think I already covered radio, and yeah, mobile vans. This is something you'll have to do in a small town. When you are going to organize camps and stuff, you start about a week in advance, you send it to the interiors, you have someone who's announcing on a loudspeaker, and you know, that's probably the only way you can do it, because in the rural areas, people are not going to come to us. There's no central MG road or a crossing where everyone will pass by and have a look. You have to go door to door, and you have to announce in their language and loudly for them to hear it or take a notice, because unless you are loud, they won't even pay attention. So you have to be loud. Calendars is something which I really like, because it doesn't cost much. Again, if you give it free in your OPD, everyone grabs one, and they'll be looking at your name on their wall for 1 year. Not just them, anyone walking in and out of their house will also look. So again, like I said, it's about the recall value, it's about the brand building. Suddenly people will know there is a Mahesh Netralay or a Prayag Netralay. Why? Because I saw a calendar there. Or this works on the same principle. The bags that you're giving your patients, it doesn't cost much to get your name printed on them. But if they are durable enough, they will outlast the patient's disease. So they will be hanging around or lying around in their house much longer. That will again create a recall value, which will be important. Thank you. Sorry if I've overshot my time.